गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम कमिंग विथ अ टॉपिक टाइप्स ऑफ लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर। इन दिस सेशन आई विल डिस्कस नीड ऑफ लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर, टाइप्स ऑफ लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर, कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड इट्स वर्किंग, एडवांटेजेस, डिसएडवांटेजेस एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर। सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर। द लाइटनिंग अरेस्टर protect the electrical equipment from the lightning surge. It is placed very nearer to the equipment to be protected. And when the lightning occur, the arrestor divert the high voltage wave of the lightning to the ground. And this is the way we can get the protection of the equipment from the high voltage lightning surge. The selection of arrestor depends on the various factor like voltage, current and some other factor also. The lightning arrestor is mainly classified into the 8 types. Let us discuss one by one. In this session, I will cover first two types of lightning arrestor, road gap arrestor and horn gap arrestor. Third is spear gap arrestor, then multi gap arrestor, expulsion type gap arrestor, electrolytic type arrestor, lead oxide type arrestor and last is thyroid type arrestor. So let us start with the construction of road gap arrestor. This is the figure of road gap arrestor which is connected across the bushing of the transformer. So first we will understand the construction of this road gap arrestor. It is the simplest form of arrestor. It consists of two rods. These are the two rods, 1 and 2. 1.5 cm diameter rods which are bent at right angle with a gap. This is the gap in between two rods as shown in the figure. This one rod is connected to the line and another rod is connected to the earth. One thing we have to be very clear that the distance between this gap and this insulator. I am talking about this distance from this insulator to this gap must not be less than 1/3 of this gap length. Otherwise what happen that arc may reach to the insulator. So if the distance is not less than 1/3 of the gap length, then this arc may damage this insulator. So we have to keep the distance greater than the 1/3 of the gap length. Now let us understand the working of the road gap arrestor. During normal voltage, what happened? This gap is non-conducting. So the line voltage will going into the equipment. But when the high voltage surge on the line occurs, what happened? The gap sparks and it becomes conducting. So the surge current is conducted to the earth via this rod. And in this way, the excess charge on the line due to the surge is conducted to the earth, and this is the way we can protect the equipment. So this is the working of the road gap arrestor. Now we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of the road gap arrestor. Advantages: as we have seen, the construction is very simple and cost is very less as compared to the other lightning arrestor. But there are few disadvantages for the road gap arrestor. First is arc is maintained after the suppression of the surge and normal voltage is restored. What happened? Arc is maintained for the some time. So normal voltage is restored in the power system. Second, the rod can melt due to the heat of the arc. Due to the heating of the arc, the temperature is increasing and temperature is high which can melt the rod. So this is the disadvantage of the road gap arrestor. Third is moisture in the air, temperature. These are the parameter which can affect the working of the arrestor. And due to the above disadvantages, the road gap arrestor is used only for the backup protection. This is the main disadvantage as far as the road gap arrestor is concerned. So now I will talk about construction of second horn gap arrestor. So let us understand the construction of the horn gap arrestor. This is the number one part. This is the transformer. Means we can say that the equipment to be protected, we have to protect this transformer. Second is the choke coil L. This is the choke coil L. Third is the line conductor. This is the line conductor. And fourth and fifth, these are the two rod A and A dash. The horn shape rod, we can see that these are the two rod, and there is a gap in between these two rods. This rod A is connected to line via limiting resistance. Through this limiting resistance, A is connected to line via this limiting resistance, and another rod A dash is connected to the ground. So these are the construction of horn gap arrestor. Now I will discuss working of the horn gap arrestor. Now friends, what happen during the normal condition? The line voltage, this line voltage will be going into the choke coil. So this choke coil will offer a very low reactance to the line voltage, and it will pass through the equipment. So during normal condition, line voltage is coming to choke coil, it offer low reactance and it will directly pass into the equipment. But what happen when there is a high voltage surge condition is there? At that time, this choke coil will not allow the high voltage to pass through this equipment. This choke coil, it will offer high reactance due to the high frequency of the surge. So what happen? It will divert the path. It will divert, and that voltage will appear across this resistance. So the voltage difference in between A and A dash is such that it breaks the gap. And what happen? This non-conducting gap will become conducting. So the surrounding air is ionized, and that is why the current is flowing from this limiting resistance to this gap to this rod A dash, and from this rod A dash to earth. And this is the path how the overvoltage will be discharged. So I repeat, when there is a high voltage surge or the surge condition, then that voltage will pass through this limiting resistance. Through limiting resistance, it will go to this rod A. Due to the ionization, it will pass from A to A dash and from A dash to earth. And this is the way how the overvoltage surge can be discharged through this path, and that overvoltage will not going into the transformers, and we can save these transformers. Now I will discuss advantages and the disadvantages of the horn gap arrestor. Let us start advantages. In the horn gap arrestor, arc is self-clearing, so it does not cause short circuit of the system after surge is over, as in the case of the rod gap arrestor. Friends, what happen in the rod gap arrestor? In the rod gap arrestor, small voltage is sufficient to maintain the arc in the rod gap. But as far as the horn gap arrestor is concerned, a very high voltage is required to maintain the arc. So that is the very good advantage of the horn gap arrestor is concerned. Second is small voltage. Magnitude of the current decreased due to the series resistance. As we have seen that limiting resistance is there in the circuit. So magnitude of the current will decrease due to this series resistance. But at the same time, there are few disadvantages also with this type of arrestor. So let us start disadvantage. Number one is bridging the gap between horn by some external object can make the device useless. Friends, we have seen that sometimes bud or the branches of the tree which will bridge the gap. So what happen? It will make the device useless. That is the limitation of this type of arrestor. Second, setting of the horns get affected due to the corrosion, and so its performance is affected. What happen? Corrosion or the pitting, it will change the length of the gap. So the proper operation of lightning arrestor is not achieved. And last but the most important, the time of operation of arrestor is long. It is about 3 seconds. And this time is far long as far as the power system is concerned. Nowadays, feeder will go for the some other arrestor, which will give protection up to 1 second. So these are the disadvantage of the horn gap arrestor. Thank you very much for watching my video.